Amid continuing tensions at the LAC, the Chinese side has expressed its willingness or its desire to hold talks with India, essentially at the defense minister level. Now, can talks between Defense Minister Rajnath Singh with his Chinese counterpart help diffuse the situation? Is diplomacy the way forward, as External Affairs Minister Jay Shankar said yesterday? To answer these questions, Snehesh Alex Philip is with me this Friday. So start sending in your questions for Government Matters. Snehesh, so first let's talk a little bit about what is happening right now since, you know, I think we had a chat earlier this week. What has changed since then, if at all? What is the situation right now at the border?
Well, the situation hasn't really changed since then. The situation in Eastern Ladakh continues to remain extremely sensitive. The other day I was speaking to someone and I asked that person, so how sensitive is this situation? So he said sensitive is an understatement. So you can very well understand what the situation is really out there. Now, what has happened over the last weekend is the fact that India has gone ahead and dominated the entire southern bank area. Now we've captured a number of heights there. We dominate the passes there. And so before that, there's a clarification that remember that these are areas which India considers to be as part of its own territory. So the LAC. However, these areas were disputed in the sense that the Chinese also used to claim, saying that it was their area. This similarly what happens in the Northern Bank also. For example, the Indian positions are permanently based at Finger 2. And we have an ITP post at Finger 3. However, till Finger 8, it is not dominated per se. But yes, the Indian teams used to patrol. The Chinese used to stop us from patrolling. And the Chinese also did not have any post between Finger 4 and Finger 8, even though they claimed it as their territory. Okay. They used to have a post much behind, which is the Sirija post. However, in May, they came in and built positions and occupied the territory from Finger 4 to 8. Similarly, India has done in the southern district.
Right.
So what, today I've done a story. If you haven't read it, please log on to ThePrint.in and read the story, in which I've said that new rules of engagement are at play in southern Ladakh. And this, the new rules of engagement have actually helped in ensuring that the situation over the weekend did not spiral. This is primarily because certain tactical actions were taken. Tactical warnings were given to the Chinese army, when they started approaching this particular territory.
So, what are these new rules of engagement?
Well, the new rules of engagement is the fact that the local commander, the commander on the ground, has now the power to decide if and when and he can use any kind of equipment at his disposal that can be used. It could be a rocket launcher, it could be a light machine gun, it could be a rifle that the soldiers use, or anything for that matter. So the decision has been left to the local commander. Now you would ask why there was wasn't the case earlier. No, it was not the case earlier. Remember that in Galwan we had the death of 20 Indian soldiers, and no matter what, it was a very brutal fight that happened. You also had casualties on the confirmed casualties, but undeclared casualties. Confirmed because yes, the casualties have taken place. Undeclared because Chinese have not yet given out the casualty figures. So this was a free for all kind of a fight. It was a fist fight. The Chinese had used crude weapons. The Indian soldiers who had reached up there, not everybody were armed, and and primarily this is all to do with an agreement that India and China had signed years ago, under which there would be no use of firearms, in the sense opening of shots that would be fired or any kind of blast that would take place within the 2 kilometer radius of the LAC. So all the action that is happening right now is within the 2 kilometer of the LAC itself. But however, now the rules of engagement have changed. I'm not getting into the specifics of what exactly happened. The army has said that they would not like to comment on the tactics that was used. Sure. But the army has said that they were able to dissuade the Chinese from coming in. So I'll leave it at to that.
Right.
However, I also like to clarify, contrary to what a lot of things or speculations are there out in the social media, that there was no clash between the two troops. And that is why I said the new rules of engagement prevented
a clash,
spiraling of the situation, because the Chinese were coming in, the Indians are already occupied. So there was no clash. So if there was clash, there would have been injuries.
Snehesh, as I mentioned earlier in my introduction, the Chinese side has asked for talks with Defense Minister Rajnath Singh, who's at this point attending the SCO. Our External Affairs Minister, Mr. Jaishankar, said that diplomacy is the way forward. So we've had this conversation about talks earlier. We've had this conversation about how much talks have helped. But now going forward, can a resolution be reached, say, through talks between Mr. Rajnath Singh and his Chinese counterpart?
Well, I'm not really sure whether a resolution can be reached between Rajnath Singh and his Chinese counterpart. But I'm of the firm opinion that a resolution will come only through talks. Now, both India and China are big powers. The military might of China, even though it remains untested, it's big. So there is no way that India is going to give a crushing defeat to China, and neither can China give a crushing defeat to India. Whatever that will happen at both the sides, eventually it will be the talks that would decide the outcome, this thing that has to be there. The likely meeting between Defense Minister Rajnath Singh and his Chinese counterpart is a very positive development if it happens. It's a movement which is forward.
Right.
On the 10th also, Jaishankar is supposed to have, pull aside with his Chinese counterpart. And it is again, my colleague Nanima and I had done the stories. Like, even the action that has taken place in southern Ladakh and in the southern banks of the Pangong, so as well as in the northern bank, where we climbed up certain heights and can see, it's like a face to face kind of a situation up there, at the distance, not really very close. It has been done, and it is hoped now that these actions would actually lead to a forward movement in talks that had actually reached a deadlock in July itself. Okay. So there has been no forward movement as far as talks were concerned. However, with this action, now you've seen the Chinese are talking. So one will have to really wait and see what happens. I'm sure there would be bargain per se. There are many people who say that bargaining and stepping out from the territories that we have occupied in Southern Bank is actually, makes no sense, because you're moving out from our own territory. Remember that the border issue is still supposed to be disputed. It's not underlined. It's not been drawn anywhere. So the Chinese, there would be a barter system that would take place. The Chinese would make some, would have to step back in some places. The Indians would have to step back in some places. So
Okay. All right. Manoj Yadav, are we going to face a two-front war? If yes, are we expecting the US to intervene? In fact, yesterday, CDS General Bipin Rawat did warn Pakistan against any misadventure at a time when there were issues with the US.
This is something that has been a matter of concern too. If you've been following the print, and if you're not, do follow the print. We have repeatedly mentioned that the Indian military is preparing for a collusive threat from Pakistan and China. Now, remember that when this crisis first broke out in May, the Chinese government have remained, the Pakistani government, the Pakistani military has remained very silent. And this is surprising. Usually they would expect, Pakistan to heat up the western borders when the pressure is there on the northern borders. So it is now felt that towards the winter, the Pakistan army could collude with China in exerting pressure by heating up the western front, so that our focus gets divided. So in the north, so you remember that India is in a very precarious situation, because on both sides you have two countries which are not really friendly with India.
Right.
So on the western front you have Pakistan, so that front is usually always heated up. If that heat, there's also the northern front with China, which is already heated up again. And then the Chinese, with India and China, you also have the eastern front. So China has a very long
border.
So you will have at all the three locations, you know, the situation could become drastic, and that is something which is being taken care of. And that is why we've said that the Indian military, and that's why you have the Air Force, the Navy, and the Army, all the three which have been put on high operational alert. The many movement that have taken place, I'm not getting into the exact movements per se, but you would, that is something that has been kept in mind.
Right. Gaurav Chamania, is China searching for a face-saving move to exit the current situation? I mean, has it also now become about the bully not being able to know when to stop bullying and how to say that I'll stop bullying now?
Well, there is no doubt about the fact that China would eventually need to have a face saver per se, in terms of, because they've brought it up to such a level that they would need something to actually step back, because it also eventually affects President Xi Jinping's prestige and image that he has within the country and outside. There is no doubt about the fact, but I'm sure that the Chinese, I think I'll cut a little slack for the Chinese here, and I will say that I'm sure the Chinese would have taken all this into account. Remember that India's action in southern bank as well as in the northern banks and other areas have come only now, this sudden aggression which was there. And I'm sure this was primarily because we were building up our defenses. Now we've reached a very comfortable position. There are enough of men and equipment that have been pumped into the area. You have enough of acclimatized soldiers that are available. The backup has been made, and now the winters are coming up. Now winters is something, there's a whole lot of work that is going on for winters too.
Right. This is a YouTube user who goes by the name Master Blaster Studio. Could be a Tendulkar fan. What can talks between Rajnath Singh and his Chinese counterpart achieve amid the LAC tension? So that actually really is the crux of what we are discussing today.
Well, as I said earlier, I'm not saying that the talks between Rajnath Singh and his Chinese counterpart would diffuse the entire situation. However, when two leaders speak to each other, they are able to come to an understanding, which is then sent down through the channels and down to the ground commanders. So you will always have some sort of a forward movement per se. And I've always, otherwise also I've maintained the fact that talks are necessary. It's a positive thing that India and China are talking to each other. The talks haven't broken down. And it is hoped that more eventually the whole situation would be resolved.
Right. There is a question from Kisalaya Jha. Has India sent some of its warships to South China Sea?
The India has gone ahead, and you would have seen the story on the print. India has gone ahead and deployed a number of ships, actually almost the entire Western and the Eastern fleet into the Indian Ocean region. As far as South China Sea is concerned, it's Indian ships have gone through the South China Sea. These are important sea routes,
right,
of navigation, and those things keep happening.
Right. There's a question from, let me take this question by Abhinav Agarwal. Can you comment on the capability of the Air Force from both sides to operate effectively in such terrain and heights?
Well, as I mentioned earlier in the past also, in the stories also, as far as the Air Force is concerned, the India has an advantage over China. Now, why would you ask? Is I'm just, if you go by just pure logistics only, the Chinese air fighter bases are much away from the LAC. They are at a higher altitude than the Indian ones. So they are at about distance of 300, 400 kilometers away at a higher altitude than the Indian ones. Higher altitude and the distance means that you can't really be armed to the teeth. The fuel consumption goes higher. The fuel capacity goes lower. In comparison to India, you have number of bases that are there. We of course have it in Leh Ladakh area, but also we have it all across surrounding areas where it just takes 20 minutes to reach Ladakh.
Right.
So as far as the Air Force is concerned, it's advantage India.
India. Okay. Very quickly then, Pritam Jyoti Bora, while we rejoice the recent Indian military action in Pangong, so what is the way forward to get back all the captured territories fortified by China with military hardware and settlements?
Well, as I said, eventually, the Chinese will have to withdraw from these positions So one will have to really wait and see how this goes about, how this happens. As I said, the situation in Ladakh continues to remain very sensitive, and all it just takes is, you know,
one spark,
you know, as you have a person with a good aim, it can be from any side, from China or India, to actually to turn the situation completely out of hand.
Right. I'll take one last question. Kostav Sokar, looks like this is an end game. Do you think this will culminate into a Modi-Xi summit? So, you know, that's what we've been discussing. I've discussed this with you. I've discussed this with Noinama as well, who tracks diplomacy for us, that is this leading to a Modi-Xi summit? Is that the only way talks at the highest possible level to resolve the situation?
Well, if the situation does warrant, I think it would be the talks only at the highest possible level that will resolve this issue. The talks at the brigadier level, talks at various levels will not happen until and then there is some kind of understanding between the two sides at the highest level. There is no doubt about it.
Right.
But however, it was also, the eventual feeling that one gets from these talks that have happened over the past 3 months is the fact that China is expecting, the highest authority here in the country to call his counterpart there. But India doesn't want to do that at this moment. You know, India. So one will really have to wait and watch how this really turns out. But eventually, as I repeatedly said, eventually it's going to be the talks that will resolve this situation. No other things, be it military action or what, it would be limited. It was not going to resolve the situation.
Right. Well, we are sorry. We are having to rush through a little bit. We're not being able to take all your questions. We have another live coming up at 5 p.m. It's a panel discussion, which is called Reimagining India's Health System, Innovating to Improve Access, which will have eminent public health experts, subject matter experts, etc., which is really ThePrint is a digital partner. So this is a digital collaboration. Do log in at 5 o'clock to watch this. Thank you for watching Government Matters, for sending in your questions. Have a good weekend.